East, everyone along the coast from the Carolinas to New Jersey is keeping a close eye on Hurricane Isabel. NASA is also monitoring the huge storm churn through the Atlantic using its satellites. It's putting the images on its NASA.gov website if you want to check them out. These pictures of Isabel were taken over the past 2 days as it moved toward the U.S. The storm has lost some of its power over the past few days and was downgraded to a Category 3 yesterday afternoon. But on Saturday, it was still a Category 5 hurricane. And that's when ABC's Mike Von Friend flew right into it.
From their base in the Virgin Islands, hurricane hunters are preparing to fly directly into Isabel's eye. They have just received a forecast that this storm may be re-intensifying after weakening slightly over cooler waters. Before we take off, the pilot says he's determined to maintain the crew's remarkable safety record.
Be real careful and make sure everything's strapped down when we do our penetrations, okay?
The Lockheed P-3 turboprop is designed to take an incredible beating.
Power's good. Rotate.
The hurricane hunters say there's been only one mission where the crew never made it back.
The plane is pretty safe, and we haven't lost a plane in the Atlantic since 1955. So in a Category 5 storm called Janet.
The fact that we are now flying directly into another Category 5 is not lost on anyone.
It's in the back of your mind, sure, but you can't be thinking about that the whole time.
I'm always very apprehensive the first time I penetrate a hurricane. It's only natural. We are all that way. And yes, I do get scared.
An hour into our flight, the plane begins to shake violently.
Looks like we're going to be entering some red here. Okay, the seatbelt light's on. Seatbelt light's on.
We are now penetrating the eye wall, the most fierce winds that Isabel has to offer. This 28-year-old plane is being battered by winds in excess of 150 miles per hour.
3, 2, 1, drop. Out.
As the plane and the scientists inside begin to take a beating, small cylinders shoot out from the bottom of the plane into the belly of the beast.
You got one in the hole, one in the hole.
The canisters, about the size of a can of tennis balls, are packed with sensors that relay wind speed instantly to onboard computers mounted on shock-resistant springs. As we bust through the eye wall, suddenly a moment of calm, the serenity and beauty of Isabel's eye. It is in the eye that the scientists realize the sensors have just captured an historic measurement.
205 knots. 205 knots. Yeah, that'll be the highest ever seen.
105 knots.
That is an incredible 236 mile per hour gust of wind, the highest ever recorded by a reconnaissance aircraft.
I've been in some very strong storms before, but this is about the strongest I've been in.
How unique an opportunity is this for scientists like yourself to learn about hurricanes when a storm gets this big?
Well, first of all, we rarely get a storm like this, so we rarely get into it and make these kinds of measurements.
The extreme conditions this flying laboratory is recording is an ominous sign for those now in Isabel's path. Mike Von Fremd, ABC News, in the eye of Hurricane Isabel.
Wow.
Incredibly brave, those meteorologists.
Yeah,
I mean, flying into the storm, and it's incredible. As soon as they hit the eye, the sunshine, how calm it was. For more on Hurricane Isabel, you can track us.
It's coming up. When we come back, we'll bring you all the sports, more news, and a portion of the news brought to you by Dove Facial Care.